is to become a partner. On these cards that we passed out last night, they're at the table. If you scan the QR code, you can sign up to become a monthly partner. And if you participate with a minimum of $25, you get a free book from Jennifer this weekend. But you do need to sign up before the school is over this weekend. So we love you. If anything you've heard us say this weekend is we love you, that we're here for you. And we're inviting you to be a part of something bigger, because guess what? You're carrying a revival fire back to wherever you live. That's why you're here, and that's why we're here. Because we believe that the fire of God is stirring something up this weekend, and now he's sending out the embers. You are the ember of fire wherever you live. Amen?
Amen.
So if you've got questions about partners or anything like that, please come see me tonight or tomorrow. And like I said, you get a free book from Jennifer if you sign up tonight. Amen?
Amen.
Yep, do the website. On the card. Did I say that? Did I not do a good job? Okay. You can scan the QR code and you can sign up to be a partner. Jennifer's not listening. It's fine. She'll be right back. You can sign up through the card. There's a little QR code. Just click on it with your camera phone. If you're techie, just come see me and we'll get you signed up to be a monthly partner. Amen.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. We love you. Thank you, Victor. It is so fun to me to get to see partners, because some of you I get to talk to through email. I respond to partner emails, so it's really fun when I get to see some of our sweet partners at the schools and things like that, because it's just fun. It's fun because I feel like I know you. It's actually fun just with schools in general. It's like when you guys come to events later on, it's like, man, I saw you at the school. It feels like we have a connection, and it's really sweet to our hearts. These events and these longer events where we get to do a school and be with you for a longer period of time is actually really sweet to our hearts, because we feel that connection with you. And we get to see the Lord as he progressively heals you throughout the weekend, and that is a beautiful gift to our hearts. And so it's a really sweet time. We're going to go ahead and receive the offering. And I just want to say, when you are sowing into the offering, what you're sowing into is our ability to be able to provide these schools at no charge. That has been our heart from day one with these schools, is that you get to come and receive without having to pay a registration fee. We know that there's financial restrictions for people, and we always want the opportunity for you to be able to come and not be held back by finances. So when you sow into the offering, what you're sowing into is the opportunity for us to then take it to the next school, and to the next school, and to the next school. And this year we've had 8 schools, we will have by the end of the year, 8 schools. And that is the most we've done yet. Yeah, I say that because I'm sure that next year it'll be like 10 or 12. So it's fine. It's fine. Once a month, we like it. We enjoy it. It's fun. But that's part of what you're sowing into tonight, is us being able to provide this for the next set of people that can come and receive and get the impartation of deliverance, get the impartation of trauma healing and all that that entails. So that is what you're sowing into tonight. And I know we're anxious to get started, so I'm just going to pray, and I'm going to just ask the Holy Spirit to come into this place, and then you can come on forward. Father, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for the power of your Spirit that is here even in this moment right now. Lord, it has been felt throughout the entirety of this day. Just your sweet presence that has been here to minister, to love on your kids, to impart wisdom and understanding. And Lord, we say thank you. Our hearts are full of gratitude that you are here to meet us in this moment, in this place, at this time. Lord, we invite you freshly to do whatever you want to do tonight. And I pray for every heart that is in here would receive the fullness of what it needs tonight. And I pray a blessing over every person and every sacrifice and every family member and every person that they want to impact as they go home. I pray, Lord, that you would go before them even now, that you would begin to do the work, you would begin to stir hearts so that when they go home, that it is an easy work that you have called them to. So Lord, I pray for your spirit to come and rest. In Jesus' name, amen.
You guys are
welcome to come on forward.
Jesus, love. from my soul. Jesus, I'll never let you go. You're taking me from my grave. Set my feet upon the rock.
Thank you. stop, cause you won't stop. I won't stop, cause you don't stop. I'll worship you until the end. Jesus, you're the lover of my soul. Jesus, well, I will never let you go. Taking me from the mighty grave, set my feet on the rock. Now I know I love you. I need you. Though my world may fall, I'll never let you go. You're my Savior, my closest friend. I will worship you till the very end. You deserve it. All I worship, all I praise. You're
Hey! Oh Jesus, you found me. In the darkest of night you found me. In sorrow and blight you found me. When I couldn't fight you found me. In the darkest of night you found me. You found me. You found me. I'm so glad that you found me. You found me. You found me. You found me. You found me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Him
let go of your heart, let go of your hands.
I'm desperate for you.
This is the air.
Yeah. Oh, here. Continue worshiping. Continue praising. Continue worshiping. Continue praising. This front is open. This front is open. If you need prayer, if you have oppression, you need things broken off, you need to press in. You've got to press in to the Lord. I know there's a lot of people in here, but God is moving right now. We can press in. God can move. God can move. God can touch each one of you. The fire of God is on you in your seats. Just let Him keep burning. He's burning trauma out as you worship, as you praise, and you lift your head, and you stretch out your arms. There's an anointing here to heal that trauma and cast out demons out of your body. All it takes is your surrender. 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 Right where you are, just surrender. The anointing is here. You don't have to wait for our hands. We see people delivered of demons and trauma all the time. We never touch them. Right where you are. Holy Spirit, I ask right now for the gift of faith to come on your people because your anointing is here. God, whatever it is they need for agreement, to come into agreement with your power that's in this room, I pray right now for your hand to come on them. Holy Spirit, you lay your hand on them right now. The ones that need freedom, come on, if that's you, lift your hands to them. Come on, lift your hands, lift your face. Every place of trauma has to exit bodies right now. Trauma leaves. I speak the love of God to every place where trauma came in. I speak the love of God to the root of trauma right now, to minister to that root of trauma. And trauma is leaving bodies right now. Just let it go. That's right. You just let it go. Exit these bodies. Every place where your cry was suppressed, you have permission in this place to cry out to the Lord, to let your tears come, to let your cries come. You have permission. We allow this here. We allow the crying and the wailing and the screams and the moans. Let it out, friend. Let it out, daughter. Let it out, son. Right here in the presence of God. Right here. God says, I want to hear your voice.
With your precious grace.
stand up in the presence of the Lord. If you need ministry from the Holy Spirit, you need to stand up in the presence of the Lord. You need to stand up in the presence of the Lord. You need to stand. Stand, 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 stand with expectancy. Stand with expectancy. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Come on, don't disengage.
Holy, 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 is the Lord God Almighty.
Than everything else that's ever spoken to us. Every lie of the enemy. Holy Spirit, speak love into the deepest places. In our souls, in our minds, speak love into every cell of our body. Speak love into every brain synapse. Speak love into every living tissue, every organ. Speak love into our blood. Speak love into our systems of our body. Speak love, God, every place of our mind, soul, body, or every part of our being. Every part, Lord, speak love right now. Speak love, Holy Spirit. I speak love in those places. Come on, right now, you're going to start feeling the Holy Spirit begin to touch your mind and your body. Let them in. Breathe them in and let them in by faith. It's that simple. The anointing is here in the room. God moves in mass waves of healing. You do not need hands. Come on, every person in this room can be healed right now. Every person, every single one. No one should be going home with trauma. The anointing is here to lift trauma. No one should be going home with trauma. That's what today was about. I'm telling you right now, by the permission of the Holy Spirit, you have permission to be healed of your trauma. I don't know how to give you any more permission. You have complete permission right now to let go of all your trauma and all your pain and to weep it out and cry it out and let love come in. Let love come in. Be loved. You are forgiven. You are loved. You are valued. You are cherished. You are wanted by God. You're accepted by God. I speak the truth in you right now. You're accepted by God. You are wanted by God. Every lie of the enemy, we just counteract it with the truth and the love of Jesus. Holy Spirit, speak. Come on, He's speaking into you. I can feel Him so strong, barely talk. That's love speaking. Let Him speak. Let Him speak. Leave this room. In the name of Jesus Christ, every place of trauma that's been trapped in your bodies, Holy Spirit, I need your help. I need you to go in and dig underneath all the things, all the lies, all the clouds, all the things that the enemy has built up in every soul in here. And I need you to go down deeper, God, underneath every single one of it. I need you just to scoop up the trauma and the pain, Holy Spirit. I need you just to take that up. children in here that are trapped, that have been caged and imprisoned. I need you to rescue the little girls. I need you to rescue the little boys where they don't know how to get out. They don't know where the lock is. They don't know where the door is. Holy Spirit, I'm asking for your mercy. I'm asking for your grace that you would unlock the door. Unlock the prison now in Jesus' name. And I command trauma to leave. That's all right. Let it leave. That's all right. You let your trauma leave. You let your trauma leave. Don't worry about somebody else. Let your trauma leave right now. Come on.
Right now, out of every person right now in here. Through the Jesus, I believe I'm free.
receive his love. Come on, he's on your body right now. Is on your body right now. What's that say to your heart?
Holy God Almighty,
you are holy.
So good.
stills
the storm. Keeps getting better. He quiets the sea. He stills the storms in me. Keeps getting better. Keeps getting better.
Oh, here, you wouldn't be here. He called you here.
Thank you.
to you. Walking into those
home. I'm traveling for my life. Get up, get up, get up out of that grave. Would you get up, 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 Share my love.
Holy, you are the holy anointed one.
Thank you for choosing to come and lay your life down so that we can live. You gave us life. We wouldn't even be here. You let us live. You let us come alive. It's a joy to live for you. Oh, I pray, God, and please help us get out of our flesh. Yeah. Our spirit man cries out for you every moment of the day. We need our spirit to come alive again. Holy Spirit, we're asking for a fresh baptism of desire for you. Desire for Jesus. God, make us drink of it. We're asking for you. We're inviting you, Holy Spirit, to come and give us a passion for the things of God. We need your help, God. We can't do it without you. We can't do it without you. So we worship you again and again and again and again, because you're the only one that brings satisfaction to our soul. We want to thank you, Holy Spirit, for coming and setting your children free tonight. For the way, God, that you just come in and you move like waves. I don't understand it. I just know it because I want you. We don't understand it. But we've learned to follow you, Holy Spirit, and you come in these waves. And it's always new and it's always fresh. And I don't know how you do that, but you do it every time. I just want to acknowledge you. I'm thankful. I want to acknowledge before my friends tonight how thankful I am to the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You come and you can come in, Lord, and you can do it all by yourself, Holy Spirit, but that's not what you chose. You could just come in and do it all by yourself, but you didn't want to. You wanted a friend. You wanted a family to walk people through healing. You chose to come and place your Holy Spirit in earthen vessels so that you could flow through us into others. This is your way. This is your choice. So we yield and we say, yes, we will serve you. Great Holy Ghost, we will serve you. And whatever you want. I want to acknowledge before we close tonight the Holy Spirit has come in. You are the one that has healed the trauma. You are the one that is driving out the demons. You are the one causing us to teach, preach, and play worship to you. We know it. But we want to publicly declare it. We are nothing and you are everything.
Amen. Amen.
You look at all your broken kids in here tonight and you say, you know what? You're everything to me.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're everything to me.
Thank you, Lord.
And every time we meet, Lord, you pick up the servant towel and you wash every foot.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everyone. My heart is burning. I can feel the heart of the Lord. This has been new for me. This only happened for the first time in Michigan with these guys when they were leading worship on the fourth night at the tent. And my heart started burning all day. I said, Lord, what is this? And the whole message about that day was about family. And so now I'm talking about this and my heart is beginning to burn because I'm talking about something that burns in his heart. He burns to serve us. He burns to wash our feet. He burns for his family. He burns for you to understand that humility of his heart, of how he wants to come love you. He burns for that. And we are causing his heart to burn with our worship tonight. That we're just loving him. It's all he really wants. He just wants
wants us to love him.
So we love you, Lord.
Yes.
We love you. We love you. May your heart be blessed by this tonight. May you be blessed, God.
So Lord, I pray over my friends tonight. We're preparing to sleep in the glory of the Lord. That your heart would be healed. That you would never feel rejected by God again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he does not reject you. He fully welcomes you into his arms.
Yes.
And the way he comes in with his reckless love, which isn't reckless, it's completely on purpose. I'm going to write a song called On Purpose Love. Knows exactly what it's doing, love. He knows exactly what he's doing. Sometimes it takes me a minute to catch up to you, but Lord, I'm trying hard. Trying, Lord, I'm coming. I'm almost there. I think maybe I'm almost caught up. I'm just kidding. I'll never catch up. He's going to keep running because he's so full of fire and passion. He's going to keep running after us. And if you want to grab on with Jesus and grab his hand, he will take you to run with him through the harvest fields.
Yeah.
And he wants to do it with you, friend. Don't ever let the devil lie to you. God's passion is, it's literally relentless. He's never going to hold back. He's never going to slow down. He's never going to stop. He's going to keep going. It's the rhythm of the wave. It's the rhythm of the ocean. It's the rhythm of the wind. It's all the sounds throughout the earth. This is the Holy Spirit. This is him speaking. This is him moving. And he's doing the same thing in his church. He's going to keep moving. So let's say yes. Let's let all that God wants come in our meetings and our families and our churches and our prayer meetings and our homes and in our children and our marriages. And this is my husband, by the way. Say hi to my husband. There he is. Mr. Martin. There he is. Let him come into everything in our lives. Amen. In our jobs and our workplace, there's no limitation, friend. There's no limitation. You can go into the deep with God every moment of your life, wherever you are. You could be there. You could live in it. And live in it.
Thank you, Jesus.
I pray the Holy Spirit distracts you all night as you prepare to sleep, that he just keeps waking you up just to hug you and give you kisses all night long. Amen. But your sleep will be still perfect even though he woke you up. Because nothing missing, nothing broken, 12 baskets left over. So we can also stay up all night if we want. According to that, just sit with Jesus all night while we're getting the time for our sleep. Amen. So we're going to worship a song and we kind of transition out of here. And you're welcome to go, but you're also welcome to linger. If the Holy Spirit's on you, please don't move. I know he's really strong right now. So if he's on you and you're like under, like weeping or something, please just stay there. Okay, we're not asking you to break that flow. The rest of us are going to worship as we prepare to go out. Amen. Can we stand? And let's just give God the glory. All the praise. I'm so filled with all the gifts right now. I might need an usher. Or in this case, a husband. I'm glad I have one. Anybody need a husband? I'll be able to pray for it. So that they can do this.
I'm never going to
let your heart.
Yes, that means I'm supposed to leave.
You don't have to feel it. Thank you.